So hello everyone and a very good evening to all of you. Welcome back once again to another session of PIB 247, where we are going to discuss, guys, some more questions from the PIB news which are relevant for all the government exam and especially for the upcoming RBI grade B. And RBI grade B bus is ab aa hi gaya hai 28 mein, so around 9 days are left for the exam. And for this time, please don't do anything new. Is samay kuch bhi naya karne ki koshish mat karna. Just do only those things which you have covered till now. Just focus on revision and revision and revision. That's it. कोई भी नई चीज करोगे तो वो आपको बैकफायर कर सकती है इस समय, राइट? और अगर मॉक टेस्ट में नंबर नहीं आ रहे हैं तो कोई बात नहीं है. मॉक टेस्ट में नंबर जनरली नहीं आते हैं, ठीक है? तो उससे परेशान होने की जरूरत नहीं है. डोंट गेट स्ट्रेस्ड अबाउट दैट. और यस, थोड़ा सा आप में से कई लोग होंगे जिनको डर लग रहा होगा, तो ठीक है, दैट इज नेचुरल. अगर आप एग्जाम देने जा रहे हो, डर तो लगना ही चाहिए थोड़ा बहुत. बिल्कुल बिल्कुल ही कूल होके जाओगे एग्जाम देने के लिए तो भी अच्छी बात नहीं है, थोड़ा बहुत जरूरी है. बट यस, प्लीज ट्राई कि वो जो आपका डर है वो एंग्जाइटी में कन्वर्ट ना हो, ठीक है? क्योंकि अगर वो एंग्जाइटी में कन्वर्ट हो गया तो एग्जाम में आती हुई चीजें गलत होंगी, और वो सबसे बड़ा ब्लंडर होता है एग्जाम में, जब हम आती हुई चीजों को गलत करते हैं, राइट? सो प्लीज डोंट डू दैट. आराम से, धीरे से, प्रॉपरली रिवाइज करते रहो. ज्यादा कोई परेशान होने वाली बात नहीं है. इट इज जस्ट एन एग्जाम. कोई जंग पे आप लड़ने नहीं जा रहे हो जहाँ पे आपकी जिंदगी और मौत का सवाल है. सिर्फ एक एग्जाम है, ठीक है? तो अच्छे से करो, बस रिवाइज करते रहो और कूल होके जाओ एग्जाम देने के लिए. कोई टेंशन वाली बात नहीं है. ऑलराइट, एंड लेट्स बिगिन विद टुडे सेशन. एंड इफ यू वांट टू एस द एग्जाम दिस ईयर, सो विदाउट एसिंग योर आंसर राइटिंग स्किल्स, यू कैन नॉट एस दिस एग्जाम, ठीक है? सो फॉर दैट वी हैव लॉन्च्ड अ डिस्क्रिप्टिव राइटिंग कोर्स एक्सक्लूसिवली, विच इज मेंट एक्सक्लूसिवली फॉर डिस्क्रिप्टिव राइटिंग स्किल्स. ऑलराइट, एंड इफ यू वांट टू एनरोल इन दिस कोर्स, यू कैन डाउनलोड द अनुज जिंदल ऐप और यू कैन विजिट टू anujjindal.in. ऑलराइट, so let's talk about the very first question. And in today's session, guys, remember there are only 5 questions, theek hai? Wo bhi bahut chote chote question hai, to achhi baat hai, zyada news nahi hai, to aapko kam padhna padega. Name the portal launched by the Ministry of Communication for speeding the process of centralized right of way approvals. Now, who is the Minister of Communication? It is Mr. Ashwini Vaishnav, and he is also the Minister of Railways, of course. So this portal has been launched by Ministry of Communication. ठीक है, नाउ द नेम ऑफ द पोर्टल इज व्हाट? गति शक्ति संचार पोर्टल. ठीक है, व्हाट इज द नेम? गति शक्ति संचार पोर्टल. एंड इट हैज बीन लॉन्च्ड इन लाइन विद प्रधानमंत्री गति शक्ति नेशनल मास्टर प्लान. ऑलराइट, इट इज लॉन्च्ड अंडर पीएम गति शक्ति नेशनल मास्टर प्लान बाय मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन. नाउ व्हाट इज द ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ लॉन्चिंग दिस पोर्टल? व्हाट विल दिस पोर्टल डू? ये क्या करेगा? सो रिमेंबर, इट हैज बीन लॉन्च्ड, it has been developed for speeding the process of centralized right of way approvals. Now what is the meaning of right of way approvals? So these are the approvals which are obtained by the service providers. These are the approvals which are obtained by the service providers for laying down of let's say electricity line, theek hai, gas pipelines, broadband connections ki jo line hoti hai. So basically lines bichhane ke liye jo approval lete hain service providers, usse ko bolte hain right of way approvals, right? So for speeding the process of obtaining these right of way approvals, this portal has been launched by Ministry of Communication. Do remember here that the portal has been developed by MP State Electronic Development Corporation on behalf of Department of Telecommunication. And this through this portal, the telecom service provider and infrastructure providers ke paas kafi easiness ho jayegi. Now they can easily obtain the approvals for right to way, ठीक है, right of way, ठीक है? So therefore the correct answer is what? Option गति शक्ति संचार पोर्टल, option D is the correct answer, guys, to this question. All right, moving ahead to question number 2. CSIR, National Institute of Science, Communication and Policy Research, is conducting national workshop on hands-on training on scholarly publications. But the question is not that. Question is under which scheme this workshop is being conducted. This is very important question. ठीक है, और ये जो स्कीम का नाम है जनरली बहुत ज्यादा न्यूज में रहता नहीं है, ठीक है, और कोई बहुत ज्यादा इंपॉर्टेंट स्कीम है भी नहीं, तो अगर इसमें से कोई क्वेश्चन आएगा तो वो यही होगा, राइट? सो रिमेंबर, दिस वर्कशॉप हैज बीन कंडक्टेड, या यू कह सकते हो इज बीइंग कंडक्टेड, क्योंकि अभी ये चल ही रहा है, अंडर एक्सेलरेट विज्ञान कार्यशाला स्कीम. ठीक है, एक्सेलरेट विज्ञान कार्यशाला स्कीम. एंड दिस स्कीम विच इज एक्सेलरेट विज्ञान कार्यशाला is aimed at improving the productivity of postgraduate and PhD students from universities and colleges. How these things will be improved? by providing high end workshop on specific themes. जो workshop इनके लिए arrange कराई जाएंगी ताकि जो post graduate और PhD के students हैं उनकी productivity को improve कर सके, right? And this workshop is being organized by CSIR, National Institute of Science, Communication and Policy Research. Do remember this also. And this event is sponsored by SERB, which is Science and Engineering Research Board. ठीक है? So therefore, the correct answer will be what option A? Accelerate Vigyan Karyashala Scheme. Moving ahead to question number 3. Very important question. Consider the following statements regarding MOUs which have been signed between India and Nepal during Prime Minister's visit to Nepal. So you must be aware of this fact that अभी recently Prime Minister का visit हुआ था to Nepal, जिसमें वो लुम्बिनी गए थे. On बुद्ध जयंती के दिन वो लुम्बिनी में थे. And of course लुम्बिनी is the birthplace of the great Gautam Buddha. So there 6 MOUs have been signed between India and Nepal. So this question is regarding that. You have to identify the correct statement regarding those MOUs which have been signed. Alright, so these are the 6 MOUs, guys, which were signed. Number 1 MOU is between Indian Council of Cultural Relation and Lumbini Buddhist University, which has been signed for establishment of Dr. Ambedkar Chair for Buddhist Studies. So you just have to remember the organizations between which the MOU has been signed and the purpose of MOU. That's it. Second MOU, Indian Council of Cultural Relation and CNAS Tribhuvan University of Nepal, for establishment of ICCR, Chair of Indian Studies. ICCR is what? Indian Council of Cultural Relation. Again, third MOU is also signed by ICCR with Kathmandu University for the same purpose, for establishment of ICCR Chair of Studies, Indian Studies. Next MOU is between Kathmandu University and IIT Madras for collaboration in research and development. Next, another MOU between Kathmandu University and IIT Madras. This is again Madras, for joint degree level, for joint degree program at master's level. And finally, another MOU between Satluj Jal Vidyut Nigam Limited and Nepal Electricity Authority for development of Arun 4 project. ठीक है, Arun 4 project के लिए, जो कि Arun का जो project है, this is a hydroelectric project जो कि इंडिया ने ही पूरा बनाया है वहां पे. तो इसके चौथे वर्जन के लिए अगेन न्यू एमओ यू हैज बीन साइंड बिटवीन SJVN एंड नेपाल इलेक्ट्रिसिटी अथॉरिटी. और इसके पहले के भी जितने प्रोजेक्ट हैं, ऑल दोज प्रोजेक्ट्स हैव बीन डेवलप्ड बाय SJVN ओनली. ऑलराइट, सो देयरफॉर द करेक्ट आंसर, ओके, सो वी हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई द करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट. एन एमओ यू हैज बीन साइंड बिटवीन ICCR एंड लुम्बिनी बुद्धिस्ट यूनिवर्सिटी फॉर एस्टैब्लिशमेंट ऑफ डॉक्टर अम्बेडकर चेयर. दिस इज एब्सोल्युटली करेक्ट. MOU between SJVN Limited and Nepal Electricity Authority for development and implementation of Arun 4. This is also correct. And for collaboration in research and development, Kathmandu University has signed the MOU with IIT Bombay. No, this is not IIT Bombay. This is IIT Madras. Okay, so this statement is incorrect. Which means option A, only 1 and 2 will be the correct answer to this question. Question number 4 pe chalte. Which ministry has signed an MOU with Indian School of Business for capacity building of its officials under the Mission Karma Yogi program? So I hope you all aware of this Mission Karma Yogi, which is the capacity building program of the Class A officers of the Government of India, right? So Mission Karma Yogi program ke andar ek ministry ne for the capacity building of its officials, Indian School of Business ke saath MOU sign kiya hai. You have to identify that ministry. Remember, that's Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship, headed by Dharmendra Pradhan, who is also the Minister of Education. And the last question for today, where has Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment, headed by Dr. Virendra Kumar, inaugurated the Composite Regional Center for Skill Development, Rehabilitation and Empowerment of Persons with Disabilities? Alright, so where has Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment, okay, so ye Composite Regional Center hai for Skill Development, Rehabilitation and Empowerment of Persons. So remember, this has been inaugurated in Shillong. Option D, capital of Meghalaya, is the correct answer. Alright guys, so that's it for today's session. I hope all the questions are clear. So, बहुत ही छोटा session था आज का, क्योंकि ज़्यादा news थी नहीं. तो अच्छी बात है, ज़्यादा news नहीं है तो कम पढ़ना पड़ेगा, right? And I will see you in the next session. Goodbye, take care and God bless.